Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. Nuclear apocalypse would be pretty bad. So in the 1990s, most of the world's governments formally agreed to a deal to outlaw tests of nuclear weapons. To hold each other accountable, they set up a global network of sensors that pick up the low-frequency waves that nuclear explosions send over long distances. With a few notable exceptions, most countries adhere to the rules, so nuclear tests are pretty rare, and the network mostly picks up signals from other sources, like volcanoes, rocket explosions, ship engines, and even the vibrations of icebergs. This background noise is a headache for the people listening for nuclear explosions, but it's a boon for lots of other listeners who can also access the data with permission. For instance, instead of chasing down whales and attaching tracking devices to them, scientists can use their songs to estimate their locations. By listening to all the meteoroids that travel through Earth's atmosphere, we've learned that there are way more out there than what we can see, suggesting that the risk of a city-destroying meteorite is as much as 10 times higher than we earlier believed. By monitoring active volcanoes, or even setting off controlled explosions, and measuring how little of the energy boomerangs back to the sensors, scientists have found that the winds way above Earth's surface are faster and more variable than we thought, which is part of the reason our current weather forecasts aren't that great. And speaking of forecasts, data from the network's sensors also help us locate earthquake epicenters to provide better warnings about potential tsunamis. The system may have been built to detect nuclear tests, but it's led to an explosion of knowledge about our planet, and to a lot more questions. Like, what is responsible for all of the sound waves that we haven't identified yet? This video was sponsored by the Preparatory Commission for the Nuclear Test Ban Treaty Organization, or CTBTO, with financial support from the European Union. CTBTO has been mandated by 183 nations to monitor for illegal nuclear tests. If you're a researcher interested in using data from CTBTO's monitoring system to further expand our knowledge about the world, contact the organization at ctbto.org. Thanks to CTBTO for their sponsorship and for helping keep the world safe from nuclear weapons. And thanks to our friend Jesse Agar of This Place for illustrating this video.